back to World Crisis Radio. Concerning the fraud closure issue, the headline this morning is that Wells Fargo, just one bank, acknowledges that 55,000 of their foreclosures have been illegal, as in criminal, in my book. And the response from the Geithner Treasury is that they're concerned about the effect that this will have on the economy. What they mean by that is the ability of the zombie banks to foreclose and feast on your flesh. When Geithner and the Treasury say economy, they mean the derivatives merchants, right? The stock jobbers and derivatives mongers in Wall Street, not the average American homeowner. And this, again, is the problem of the Obama administration in a microcosm. Now, Obama, by temperament, education, and everything, is this. He's a creature of the foundations. His mother was part of the union-busting, manipulating Ford Foundation and or CIA. He himself has worked for CIA Front Business International Corporation, all this. But in case he ever gets any ideas, we've got him blackmailed on the Larry Sinclair complex, blackmailed on the Rezko Blagojevich complex, and blackmailed on the birth certificate and Indonesia complex. To go back to the failure of Obama, this is all essentially signposted over time. Remember that Oregon campaign speech, where Obama said, you may want to eat as much as you want, have your thermostat and your air conditioning set where you want, and drive a big car, but the world will not allow that. And it turned out that that was essentially a paraphrase of one of Zbigniew Brzezinski's latest books. Read the whole story in Obama, the Postmodern Coup, The Making of a Manchurian Candidate, the first book to call Obama a Manchurian Candidate. We then have Biden's speech to donors on the West Coast, where he says, we're looking for your support now because we're going to be disliked. We will be tested on foreign policy in the first 6 to 12 months. And by the time the year is over, we're going to be widely resented and widely hated, in effect, because we're going to do the right thing economically rather than the popular thing. Well, that's what Biden had to say. In terms of actions, Obama threw away his presidency when he voted for the bailout of the Wall Street zombie banks. Indeed, when he marshaled support for the Wall Street zombie bank bailout, arm-twisting the Congressional Black Caucus, who wanted to vote against it. It's a monstrosity, does nothing for the black community. But Obama twisted their arms. By the way, if McCain had voted against the bailout, he might have taken the presidency. Obama, by voting for the bailout, the $1 trillion for the zombie bankers and derivatives mongers, this essentially say, I'm taking the, not even surplus, but the available cash that I could use for a recovery program, and I'm giving that to Wall Street. So that's everything gone. You've essentially mortgaged your presidency to the hilt in favor of Wall Street before you even win the election. In Obama's inaugural address, compare it to FDR, right? Franklin D. Roosevelt, the money changers have left their high seats in the temple. They are responsible, incompetent. Obama, we are all responsible. We have not made the hard decisions. What hard decisions? Well, before the inauguration, he met with the Washington Post editorial board and said, we're going to tackle Social Security, we're going to try to cut entitlements, and we're going to go after Medicare and Medicaid. Medicare and Medicaid, the biggest areas of expenditure. So this is all from the point of view of austerity. And we know Obama says the difference maybe between a blue pill and an expensive operation, you should take the blue pill. He had a crisis of conscience about his mother, who was sick with cancer, getting a hip replacement operation in her last days, right? He's so concerned about the loss of resources. About $1 trillion for the Wall Street zombies. That's fine. Remember then the speech in lieu of a State of the Union in the late winter of 2009, where he essentially said, we're going to do whatever it takes to save Wall Street. And then in the spring, later in the spring of 2009, inviting Diamond Blankfein and the rest of these, Pandit the Bandit, to the White House, the leading zombie bankers, he told them, I'm the only thing standing between you and the populist pitchforks. of the American people. So he has been aware at every stage about where he was leading the Democratic Party. He's aware of his own destruction of all the progressive causes for the next 10 or 20 years. In Obama, the postmodern coup, I pointed out that the modern Christian fundamentalist reactionary movement of Robertson and Falwell and so forth, the so-called moral majority, came out of a ab reaction against the horrors of the Carter administration. And I predicted that under Obama, you would then have an ab reaction against the horrors of Obama. And this is what we see now. The militant reactionaries sprinkled with proto-fascists and racists here and there of this Tea Party phenomenon. So that's what's going on. And the only way you break out of this is programmatically. Obama is going to have a very hard time after the elections. You could see, for example, let's take the case of Congressman Peter DeFazio of Oregon. If you want to do something for a candidate, and if you haven't done anything for any candidate in the election, I would urge you to do something to help Congressman Peter DeFazio of Oregon, being a congressman who has recommended, one of the few in the Congress, the Tobin tax, the Wall Street sales tax, hedge around with qualifications, but nevertheless, it's there. He has advocated the Tobin tax or Wall Street sales tax in congressional proceedings. DeFazio is also known to be investigating Chief Justice Roberts of the Supreme Court, the head of the Rats Cabal, right? Roberts, Alito, Thomas, and Scalia. The leading light is Roberts, at least in terms of being the Chief Justice, to impeach him. The impeachment of a Supreme Court justice would be an extraordinarily refreshing event. And DeFazio, at least, has put it on the table, where Nancy Pelosi, of course, didn't want it. And DeFazio has now called for the dumping of Pelosi. DeFazio was on television the other night saying it's time to get rid of Pelosi. Nobody from that rich elitist zip code there in San Francisco should be the Speaker of the House. She has no idea of the concerns of working Americans. And DeFazio also broadly hinted that Obama should examine his conscience. He didn't have any idea of the concerns of working Americans either. So Peter DeFazio in Oregon, there's somebody worth supporting. And when this winter comes, you're going to need some people who can stand up for this. The question in the election, of course, is this about unemployment, jobs, poverty, exclusion, or is it a matter of the size of government, the deficit, and taxation? It is jobs. They all say jobs, jobs, jobs. Well, that means jobs, not the deficit, not the size of government, not tax cuts for the rich. You get the idea. The third force must appear. We'll be back in a minute.